Lee.
Let's start this. Lee?
Yeah?
I'll do what you do. Or should I pop in like you do?
You have to, no, you have to go.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. That's like my Lena. So, Lee?
Yes.
Lee?
Yeah.
So, Lee?
Yes. Yeah?
Oh, this is ridiculous. We do this for a living.
Lee.
Travis.
You remember not too long ago in Dallas, they called out Sagan and Ben for a bunch of nonsense that really wasn't their fault?
Yeah, it was their owner did that, yeah.
Yeah, well, it happened again.
Great.
But this time in Edmonton. So it's the same, but colder. Same, same, but different. Let me read you the tweet. Get your thoughts. So this is coming from Bob Nicholson. He's part of the ownership group in Edmonton. This is exactly what he said. Toby Reider will not be signed by Edmonton Oilers at the end of the year. Said this on March 21st. Still got a few games to play for
him. 7 games left.
Yeah, right? Yeah. And this is probably the worst. If Reider would have scored 10 or 12 goals, we'd probably be in the playoffs.
Oh,
now, keep in mind,
nice. Yeah.
Reider is having one of those ridiculously bad luck seasons. It's not...
His coach said that. His coach said that.
Right? Well, Hitchcock says
Hitchcock
he does everything
said
right.
He is right, but he can't score, yeah.
0 for 80 yeah. shots, which means...
That's statistically an anomaly.
He's
yeah.
going to score. He's probably going to have a good season next season.
Yeah, wherever he goes. I've got a lot of thoughts on this. Let's start with the obvious. There's one is that calling a player out before the season is ended sends the absolute wrong message to the entire team. Doesn't put anybody on blast. Just tells the entire team, we don't really care about you. We just care about your production, which is not the message you want a professional hockey team having. Andrew Ferentz spoke out about this in an article a few months ago.
Yeah.
About how like nobody in Edmonton in the ownership group cares about the team. Now, that's probably not completely true, but stupid things like this make you think that it is true. Number two, the GM has to select the team, the coach has to coach the team, and the players have to play the game. A lot of things have to work together to make a team win, okay? Edmonton has got a lot of right pieces, they got a lot of wrong pieces, and there's really no reason they shouldn't be in the playoffs other than the fact that they can't get their act together. There's no culture there. There's no decision to win. There's nothing together that makes them go other than Connor McDavid's awesome and he's got a great supporting cast. That's never enough. There are 32 teams in the NHL coming up, okay? And it's going to take a lot for teams to make the playoffs, much less win. It's very hard to win. A lot of people don't realize that. But to put on one player that his goal production is the reason they lost is stupid. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. It has nothing to do with why the team is not in the playoffs. One player. It doesn't matter who scores or not. The team wins and loses as a team and as a group. And I'm talking about ownership to GMs, to coaches, to the players. Has to work together. Stupid comment to make. At the end of the day, I guess the owners of a team can be fans of the team. I just think it's poor management. It doesn't need to happen. I think that's better done behind closed doors. The fans already say it enough. And you want your team to feel an environment where everyone believes in what they're doing. We've seen the teams that have succeeded continuously have a culture like that. Some of them aren't even doing well right now. The culture still exists. They're working towards that. Edmonton has a culture of losing ever since the late 80s, early 90s. Okay? They had a couple good seasons there in the early 2000s where they got back to the cup final with Pronger. And since then, it's just been, you know, like, fix your culture and you're fixed the team. Like, I want to see Edmonton succeed. They have one of the best players of all time on their team, and they're not succeeding because one player doesn't make a team, right? So to put that on any other player for not scoring 10 goals is just insanity to me. Wake up!
12 goals. He said 10 to 12, to be fair.
Wake up!
It's Lee and Travis on another quick shift.
You have to do the below thing.
Comment below.
I'm too mad. No, do it right.
Well, I
am. I'm coaching. Do it right. Do the finger thing and everything. Comment.
Below. With your thoughts on whether, you know, ownership should call out teams or not. Probably not. You know what? I'm just going to say it. They shouldn't. It's dumb.
It's stupid.
It's
yeah.
dumb.
Get over yourself. Get over your ego. It's not about you. The players play the games.
Dude, you're not nailing that. That was a difficult time to get those glasses on, buddy.
Practice makes perfect.
Side profile.